I recently picked up the new iPad Pro M1 third generation. And wanted to share my thoughts on it as a coder, content creator, and entrepreneur. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more tech product reviews. Also, shout out to some of these subscribers here. I see you. Some of you have been with me for so long and you're family now, and I just wanted to shout you out. Okay, let's get into it. First off, I wanted to talk a little bit about why I decided to get the iPad Pro. As someone who works from home from my MacBook Pro M1 Pro, you might be thinking, Tiff, what is the need for an iPad? What are you really going to use it for? Well, the answer is a twofold. The first reason is I'm simply a tech geek and just love trying out new products and sharing it with you. The second reason is I am going to be traveling more, and when I'm traveling, I really like to carry something light that I can still do my work on, especially when on a plane. Let's talk specs of the iPad I chose. I got the silver iPad with 128 gigabytes. It has 8 gigabytes of RAM, the Apple M1 chip, and 8-core CPU with 4 performance cores and 4 efficiency cores. I got the smallest amount of storage because I'm not really going to be storing anything on this iPad, rather just utilizing it, especially as I mentioned, when traveling. Okay, now let's talk performance. I'm going to pull up Geekbench score here and show you just how amazing performance this iPad really has. Also, in regards to performance, Apple claims that the new M1 chip is up to 50% faster in terms of CPU performance compared to the 2020 iPad Pro, which has A12Z Bionic chip. And that's pretty impressive stats, if you ask me. Okay, let's dive into battery life a little. As I mentioned multiple times, as I'm using this for traveling, battery life was very important to me. I didn't want to have to be worried about, is my iPad going to die quickly? Am I going to have to charge it on the plane? And so that was a huge factor to me that I spent some time doing research on. Apple states that the battery life is up to 10 hours when you are either surfing the web or watching a movie. Okay, getting into 5G capabilities, the 2020, I had an old iPad actually from 2020, and it only had 4G capabilities, so it was another really big incentive to upgrade to the iPad Pro 11 because it comes with 5G capabilities. Okay, from a content creator standpoint, let's talk about the camera. This is one of the exciting upgrades of the iPad Pro 11. The third generation iPad Pro 11 comes with 12 megapixel front true depth with ultra wide camera. As you can see here, when you zoom out, you will see a ton more of the environment you are trying to capture.
Okay, you're gonna see a lot of me right now, but this is essentially when the lens is zoomed out. You can kind of get a bigger picture here. I'm on video right now on the iPad, so you can kind of get a sense though, and I will switch to photos so you can see as well that the front-facing camera, you can have the option to really expand the lens, which I think is a really great feature, especially for content creators. It's something that I know I would find very useful.
Also, the new front camera allows for extra features they introduced, such as one called the center stage, where the camera will actually track and follow you during a video call. I thought it was pretty cool that if more than one person is in this video call, the camera will accommodate to that, pick up the faces, and also expand to try and fit everyone in the camera or the lens. Okay, let's answer a question that I had, which is, can you code on it? I mean, my first answer is you can code on pretty much anything, so immediately yes, but I wanted to know if this is something that I would feel comfortable coding on. Is the screen big enough for me to code on, and just really how I felt with it. My initial reaction is I wasn't certain if I was going to be able to code on it, but I actually got a external keyboard that I hooked up to the iPad, and it really makes coding on it pretty seamless. From a coding standpoint, let's get one thing clear. I am not building large applications on an iPad Pro, but rather I find it really good and I wanted something that I could use that I could practice leak code questions on, hacker rank questions on, essentially just practice algorithms. When I'm traveling, I find I usually want to, I get motivated or inspired to practice or brush up on my algorithms. It's probably the only time I actually get motivated to do so. So I always try and take advantage. let's get one thing clear. I'm not someone who loves practicing algorithms, as I'm sure most of you who code do not, but I do find when I travel or am on planes and have a lot of time on my hands that it's a good way to kind of force myself to brush up on my skill set. So that's really when I take advantage of it. I just go into the browser and go to LeetCode or HackerRank and start brushing up on it. I do find that I absolutely need to have an external keyboard. One of my favorite accessories for the iPad Pro is Logitech keyboard, and it's super easy to use, and it also acts as a case, which is a win-win. Okay, now you know some of my reasons as to why I chose to upgrade, but if these reasons or these features aren't really important to you, I would say upgrading isn't necessarily something that you really need to do. There is still a lot of amazing things on, for example, the iPad Pro 11 2020 with a lot of the same features as well. So it really has to be either the camera, the front-facing camera now. Overall, I would say if you are someone who is enticed by some of these features or specs that I laid out, I definitely think it is worth the upgrade. But if you have, for example, the iPad Pro 11 from 2020, I don't really think it's necessary unless some of these features really entice you more. For me, some of the differences, as I mentioned, that really enticed me were the 5G capabilities on the third generation iPad Pro, the new M1 chip, the RAM options, and the new front camera and Thunderbolt charging. If these reasons are all important to you, then upgrading is most likely worth it. I hope you found this video very helpful and useful if you are someone who's researching on iPads and considering upgrading. I know for me, it really felt worth it, and I really had a positive experience so far using it. Leave in the comments other products that you want to see me review. And if you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. Thanks, everyone.